Virginia-based AeroVironment has delivered two prototype high-energy laser weapon systems to the U.S. Army. The systems, known as the 20-kilowatt class LOCUST, Laser-Oriented Counter-UAS System, LWS, Laser Weapon System, are designed to detect, track, and neutralize a wide range of aerial threats using hard-kill-directed energy. Branded as the Army Multipurpose High-Energy Laser, AMP-HEL prototypes, these systems integrate AeroVironment's LOCUST LWS onto the General Motors Defense Infantry Squad Vehicle, ISV platform, providing a mobile, versatile solution for frontline air defense. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what can AeroVironment LOCUST Laser Weapon System do for U.S. military. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The U.S. Defense Department is particularly interested in directed energy systems, high-energy lasers, and high-power microwaves to protect military personnel and installations from aerial threats such as short-range drones. The general idea of laser beam weaponry is to hit a target with a train of brief pulses of light. The rapid evaporation and expansion of the surface cause shock waves that damage the target. Lasers offer several key advantages over traditional kinetic weapons. Because they operate at the speed of light, targets can be engaged almost instantaneously, with no time lag between firing and impact. Unlike conventional systems, laser weapons do not require physical ammunition. Their effectiveness is limited only by the power supply available on the platform, allowing them to neutralize a far greater number of threats in succession. Another major benefit is their precision and clean engagement profile. Lasers are silent, produce minimal debris, and greatly reduce the risk of collateral damage in crowded or sensitive environments. Cost is also a decisive factor. While traditional interceptors can be extremely expensive, a single laser shot can cost as little as $1, making them one of the most economical defensive options available. AeroVironment's LOCUST is a fielded, vehicle-integrated 20-kilowatt class directed energy weapon built to give small infantry units an organic, mobile hard-kill capability against small unmanned aerial systems and other nearby airborne threats. It is developed from work originally done under the LOCUST program, previously associated with Blue Halo, and matured by AeroVironment. LOCUST is a compact, palletized high-energy laser weapon that combines three core subsystems: a 20-kilowatt class laser source and power conditioning suite, an integrated beam control slash beam director unit with stabilized gimbal and precision optics, and a sensor and fire control stack, EO slash IR cameras, automatic trackers, and mission software that links into vehicle and higher level command and control C2 networks. Its design is sensor agnostic and plug and play friendly. The system can accept cues from radars or other sensors, run automated multi-target tracking, and direct its beam using high-bandwidth pointing and tracking loops to hold energy on small UAS airframes until structural or critical component failure occurs. The system's human interface is deliberately simple. Operators train quickly using an intuitive console and controls that streamline threat evaluation and engagement. A key selling point for the LOCUST LWS is mobility. AeroVironment integrated the 20-kilowatt LOCUST package onto the General Motors Defense Infantry Squad Vehicle, ISV, for the first AMP-HEL prototypes. Follow-on increments are planned for Joint Light Tactical Vehicles, JLTV, slash similar platforms with integrated radar and C2 packages. The palletized approach means LOCUST can be adapted to multiple host vehicles or installed as a palletized capability in containerized expeditionary roles. AeroVironment highlighted that the AMP-HEL prototyping effort is part of the Army's broader modernization initiative to rapidly develop and field directed energy solutions to defeat a range of threats, including drones and other airborne systems. Mary Klum, Senior Vice President for AV's Space and Directed Energy Group, said, "This milestone marks a major step forward in the Army's pursuit of fieldable directed energy capabilities. Through the AMP-HEL program, AV is delivering our extensively validated LOCUST laser system, a technically sophisticated solution that has demonstrated reliability and operational readiness for the C-UAS fight. We are honored to support the U.S. Army Rapid Capabilities and Critical Technologies Office, and together, accelerate warfighter access to these critical capabilities." John Garrity, Vice President of Directed Energy Systems for AV, said, "The need for these systems from real-world events is clear. The time is now for directed energy to get into the hands of warfighters everywhere, and we are confident that LOCUST meets that need. AV is committed to supporting the Army's modernization and modularity priorities. We stand ready to meet the mission need through full-scale manufacturing of our LOCUST laser systems, including AMP-HEL and other mobile and fixed-site platforms, to increase lethality and continue to build on our extensively validated reliability and precision tracking and targeting technology to address the evolving threats." The weapon is a significant advancement in mobile, frontline C-UAS capabilities. AeroVironment revealed that following integration at AV's Directed Energy Manufacturing Facility in Albuquerque, New Mexico, the AMP-HEL prototypes underwent rigorous government acceptance testing at Yuma Proving Ground in Arizona to validate performance, mobility, safety, and lethality. Subsequently, U.S. Army units performed new equipment training at Fort Sill, Oklahoma, to prepare for potential employment of directed energy capabilities. Soldier feedback from the event is shaping ongoing enhancements to ensure warfighter readiness and operational relevance in dynamic threat environments, according to a press release. It can be stated that the system is ready for real-life scenarios, and this is very good news for U.S. military. Over the last few years, drone attack on U.S. military has increased. On 28th of January 2024, a drone strike by the Iran-backed Islamic Resistance in Iraq hit Tower 22 near the Syrian-Jordanian border, killing 3 U.S. soldiers and injuring 47 others. This marked the first drone strike that resulted in U.S. fatalities in the region since the Gaza conflict began. In mid-October 2023, a drone attack caused traumatic brain injuries to 15 U.S. soldiers and minor injuries to others stationed at the base. On the 20th of October 2021, a combined drone and rocket attack struck the Al-Tanf base used by the U.S. and allied forces. There were no injuries, but it highlighted vulnerability to unmanned threats. Swift deployment of this 20-kilowatt class laser system across the U.S. bases could greatly enhance anti-drone capabilities.